Even I'm tired of watching me upgrade the TV in my living room at this point, which is why today's video is very exciting. This is the very first in what I'm planning to be a very long-running series sponsored by Intel. I'm calling it Intel Extreme Tech Upgrade, and the premise is simple. One by one, each of my team members is gonna get a $5,000 budget to tech makeover their space. First up, Anthony. Let's see how he spent it. Now you might be thinking, $5,000? With that, you could buy the most ballin' gaming PC ever. But the PC is only one part of a setup upgrade, so Anthony had to make some tough choices.
An obvious path would have been to just build a top-of-the-line gaming PC courtesy of Intel and call it a day. But I already have a pretty sweet gaming setup. And this is an opportunity to splurge on something I wouldn't normally buy for myself. Now, I've never been thin. And while I lost a fair amount of weight before moving to BC, the early days of the move caused a shift in my habits. No pots and no pans meant no cooking. So the solution was often to eat out. But it became a habit. And while my job isn't stressful in and of itself, my mind still finds ways to make it that way sometimes. And when I'm stressed, the thing I've always turned to has been food. So, one of my plans was to use the HTC Vive that Linus lent me so that I could gamify exercise a little bit as part of a plan that I had to be more active. But the Vive is still in the bin. Not for a lack of trying, I've been putting together a little ITX rig piece by piece. It's just hasn't happened yet. I managed to lose some of what I gained, even though I haven't been using the Vive, but it's not happening fast enough, and I fear I've plateaued.
So my tech upgrade is going to revolve around transforming my media setup. I'm talking new TV, new stand, new soundbar, and of course, finally installing a sick new VR gaming PC, powered by Intel, of course.
The gaming PC is still at the heart of the setup here. So Anthony, do you want to walk me through some of your parts choices here, starting of course with the CPU. So you've gone with a Core i5-10600K.
And I chose the Intel Core i5-10600K for its high clock speeds, which should help in VR.
For RAM, you've gone with 16 gigs of DDR4 3200 C16. I noticed there's no RGB, not only on the RAM, but anywhere in this system.
Yeah, if it's gonna be a living room PC, I don't especially need RGB, and I don't really want it either. I don't really need lights distracting me from, you know, the TV or anything else I might be doing in the living room.
That makes sense, and I can actually see those aesthetic choices throughout the build here. So if you want to unbox the case and maybe get the power supply installed, I'll take this over here, then we don't have to wear these annoying masks.
The Fantex P400 is actually, from what I can gather, a really good case for noise to performance ratio.
And the same can be said for the Noctua NHU-12S. This is a compact air cooler, but still gives up very little in terms of performance. I'm expecting this CPU to be running at max turbo all the time with a cooler like this one.
I really appreciate the understated look of this case and the fact that the front mesh here is extremely fine. So what this allows me to do is have the machine set up in the living room with good airflow so the fans don't have to ramp up. I'm just checking to see if I've got enough fan headers to run these fans without using the internal fan controller. That could save me from running an additional cable from the power supply. One fan header here. This one is for the AIO pump. I don't think that can be used for a fan.
I'm a big fan, of having fan headers along this edge of the board, but this is a more value-oriented Z490, so you don't have anything, unfortunately, along this edge. I think you missed one, though. There's actually two at the bottom. Chassis fan 2 and 3 are down here.
Oh, so I did miss one.
Then you wouldn't have to fool around with any of the profiling nonsense. You could just go 1, 2, 3 and use all chassis fan headers.
These fan cables are very short though.
Only one way to find out. Here you go, boss. So far, everything you've chosen has been purely practical. It's amazing how the choices change once they're spending their own money, right? The one exception is the all black version of the Noctua cooler. That costs about an extra 10 bucks. But I also noticed that your power supply, you went with a modular model instead of just a fixed cabled one. What would be the rationale behind that?
Cable management. I mean, to be fair, a semi-modular would be perfectly fine because everybody needs the ATX 24 pin, at least until ATX 12 volt becomes a thing. But
oh, you know we have one of those, right?
Oh,
I got a board and power supply. So guys, get subscribed. You're gonna see a video on the new motherboard power standard. Carry on.
The reason I went with the ARMX 2018, 650 watt actually, is because I don't need that much power. And it's one of the better rated power supplies on our forum thread, the PSU tier list. Actually considered one of the best in class. Okay, I think this is a job for your tiny fingers.
I did prove that I'm a faster PC builder than Anthony. Oh yeah, and better gamer.
I don't know about that, but the RTX 2080 Super is basically, I think, the best value for like high-end VR right now. Since I'm going to be using it with a Vive, it's probably not actually even going to be used to its full potential. So with it, I should be able to handle anything that I throw at it.
That's it, right?
Yeah, I guess so. We don't necessarily need to cable manage the back. I can do that later.
That looks about as cable managed as I would make it.
Yeah, about as cable managed as you would make it.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
Now, my basement apartment isn't exactly in great shape, and it's pretty cramped too, so that informed a lot of my decision making. Because I don't have much space for high-end audio, a good soundbar is what I was after. While I wanted to use the Sonos Arc as a standalone bar, I just couldn't get one in time. So I went for the Samsung HW-Q90R, which comes with a subwoofer and satellites. Reviews place it among the best soundbars that can handle Dolby Atmos right now. And while I'm not sure if it's strictly an upgrade in terms of sound quality over my Audio Engine A5 Plus bookshelf speakers, in terms of sound stage, it should be a huge step up. The TV is rather special. I originally was looking at the LG Nano 90, but it lacked some features that I really wanted, like multiple HDMI 2.1 ports and more than 32 dimming zones. And then Vizio launched their 2021 lineup, and their new P-Series Quantum X ticked all the boxes. 4 HDMI 2.1 ports, eARC, 480 local dimming zones, auto game mode with quick response time, 120Hz native panel speed with variable refresh rate from 48 to 120Hz. I mean, basically, for my use case of mixed gaming and content streaming, it's perfect. The only problem is it's not for sale yet. So we managed to get a pre-production model straight from Vizio themselves.
All right, buddy, got your delivery where you want it.
Oh, well, that's rude. that's a very good question.
This is kind of a lot of stuff here. Like, is this TV even gonna fit?
No.
Tell you what, why don't we build the stand and see where that gets us.
Okay.
This is going faster than it was, that's for sure. I still have my doubts about whether anyone's gonna be able to get past this stand if it's installed here, so we may have no choice but to go with our backup TV location plan there, Anthony. Why don't we leave the VR space here then?
Okay.
What I might do though is take off that mount and do it this corner to that corner though, because that way you could actually go all the way from here all the way over to here. If you wanted to play like a bigger game, like Gorn is a ton of fun to play with a little bit of room to move around, so you can, you know, punch guys. It's like a physics-based arena brawler. My location here is actually really good to watch this whole space here. A little bit tighty tight in there. There we go. While Matthias finishes up the TV stand, I think what you and I need to do clear some space.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently we're taking it one step farther and we are disassembling the desk. Now I'm really glad I don't have to be part of that conversation. Even if we're gonna make it better after we temporarily destroy this home office setup. It's worth pointing out, by the way, Intel's not just giving us special treatment. They've been helping their staff transition to working from home with budget for tools, equipment, and resources so that they can keep working through these tough times as well. And where the crap am I supposed to put this exactly?
Wherever it fits.
Okay. And that's where it goes.
Yeah. We'll figure out the cleanup afterwards.
Don't worry. That's not my problem, I guess. Not my problem. Da, 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 da. The good news is we're making progress. Matthias, are we ready for me to unbox the TV so we can put it on this mount? How close are you?
I believe we are quite close.
Looking pretty good. Did I catch it?
Whew.
All good. Everything's fine. I stomped on the back of the packaging, and that bought enough time for Anthony and David to get over and stop it from whacking on the counter. Cool. Now all we need to do is actually mount the TV to it. This whole assembly is gonna weigh like 150 pounds by the time we're done. Should we center it a bit? Yeah, that would be better.
That is massive. yeah, wow.
okay. So, oh, not bad.
Yeah,
okay.
There's a lot of range of motion on that mount, actually.
A do doop. Oh yeah. Gaming rig time. A UPS isn't the most glamorous piece of hardware ever. You know, leave it to Anthony to pick smart things to spend his budget on. It's a great idea when you have unstable power, and apparently they get frequent brownouts here, so this is just a wonderful way to protect the gear that's attached to it. So how heavy is this puppy?
It's pretty heavy. I don't think you're gonna lift it. It's in three pieces. Probably best to like kind of...
Yeah, we can, yeah, sure. Okay. Yeah. Here we go.
Hang on.
Oh boy, it's plugged in, isn't it?
Yep.
You know you must be at Anthony's house when under the couch you might find normal things like popcorn debris, but also a keycap puller. We can run power for the couch off the island now, which means all we gotta do is kinda shove these bad boys under here. Ugh. And cable managed. That's a free tech tip for you.
Tech tip. If you can't see them, they're managed.
That's right. That's management. For a soundbar, this thing is pretty crazy town. It's all Atmosy and all that. So it's 7.1.4. And basically that means you've got like four channels up top, one subwoofer, and then seven either virtual or true channels. The soundbar itself, which Anthony has over there, the subwoofer, and then this right here is a couple of rear satellites that we're planning to put on these speaker stands. I've got three things that I just brought over here that need to plug into the wall. Both of the rear satellites, and then I've also got that Vive lighthouse. So unfortunately, I think that means this shelf has got to kind of shovel off a little bit away from the wall. So here we go. Oh boy. Here we go again. Oh boy. Huh, okay. I'll try not to break your PS3.
That's the first model too, it's got PS2.
Ooh.
And the card reader and stuff.
Yeah, I really gotta be careful not to break that one then.
I've repaired it myself and I'm very proud of that.
Yep, there we go, oh, yep. If it's back here and we can't see it, then it's good. Okay there, bud. It's TV AF.
You ever seen a TV as TV? Is this TV?
I've got the subwoofer packed back here behind the couch. I know that's not ideal for acoustics, but Anthony preferred it in terms of looks, so we're gonna at least give it a shot. The soundbar itself, I haven't actually plugged into the eARC port on the TV yet, but I'll do that in just a moment. And I was just about to plug in power to the UPS. I did move a network switch over here though, so we should be good to go for networking for all the gear that Anthony is about to cart over.
If you have electronics that take 5 volts, get one of these things. USB to barrel plug. Plug it into a USB port somewhere and you can power these things so you don't have as many wall boards and it's a lot more efficient.
I'm accepting all the terms and conditions. Your life is now signed away to Vizio.
Sounds good. I'm gonna use literally none of its smart functions, I'm pretty sure.
Anthony, why do you have 3 Super Nintendos?
I don't. Those are Luke's.
Why do you have 3 of Luke's Super Nintendos?
I don't. I have 4. One of them is in pieces in a bag, and yeah, basically he wanted me to fix them up, but I haven't ever really gotten around to setting up my soldering station.
I was surprised to see those too. I thought you were a Sega loser.
Well, I was a Sega kid. That doesn't mean I can't appreciate other things, unlike Nintendo fans.
Oh yeah. Okay, so I need a keyboard and mouse, if you don't mind.
Oh,
good, sir.
Well, one moment.
Getting all the foxes together to cover up those patched holes in the wall. Hey, wait a minute. Hey! That's not a fox! No, you're done, it's out.
All right.
This one's ugly.
It's a red panda.
Oh, okay. Hey, what the? Get out of here, red panda. Deceiving me. Polar bear. Oh.
Well, look, red pandas are called Firefoxes.
Nope. So. Right. They're out. Look at all my friends. This is the closest thing I have to them. Where'd that red panda go?
I don't know, you dropkicked it.
I take it back. The red panda can return, and the Pokemon can come back. I need a solution for the patches on the walls, but like, hey, look at that!
This is something very special that I've been waiting for a long time to get my hands on. It's the open source scan converter, and it's not something we've, like, had a need to cover on the channel. Basically what it does is it takes component video, or European SCART, which can either carry a component or a composite signal, and converts it into HDMI. It can also take VGA here. And it can line double it. So basically, if it's an old game that runs at 240p, for example, newer TVs don't know what to do with that. So this will line double that, output it at 480p, and the TV will basically just accept it happily. It also, I think, can upscale further than that, and it has open source firmware as well, so it can actually apply other things like filters, different kinds of scan lines, that kind of thing. So I'm looking forward to adding this and kind of making it the centerpiece of my retro game collection as I expand upon it. Most of it's still in Newfoundland, but that's a small detail. This HDMI switch, what I'm going to use that with is this M-Cable Gaming on the output end. What that lets it do is any of these four inputs can then be pushed through the M-Cable without having to, you know, unplug and replug and all that kind of stuff. And yeah, so I'll just plug the PS4 or Wii U or PS3 or anything like that into this, and it'll be upscaled for me. No need to worry about the internal upscaler in the TV. The only problem with this thing is that it's a little bit like loud color-wise. I guess I could like plasti-dip it or something. I've already put some Kapton tape on the front of this to kind of take the edge off of these lights. They get really bright.
So we've got the Quantum X P-Series TV from Vizio, 75-inch, 2021 edition, or whatever they're calling it now. We've got the Samsung Atmos soundbar. We've got all of Anthony's console set up here. He's probably gonna add more, but you know how it is. And most importantly, we've got the wireless VR setup that theoretically I should be able to pair now. So do you wanna hold on to that? Have you ever done this before?
Nope.
Okay, cool. So basically how it works is, no, you don't put that on yet. I know, it's exciting, but you can't yet, you can't. So you just walk around the room and just draw where there's no obstructions, so where the safe space will be. Achievement unlocked, you're ready.
Cool.
Give it a shot, Anthony. Boy's a gamer.
Ah.
But it's harder than it looks. How's the experience though? How's the wireless?
It's good. Like, I'm not impeded whatsoever.
You can tell he's got music in his ears. A little loud. We've got the VR working. Do you want to also experience the soundbar? Maybe throw like some kind of content up on the Apple TV before we go?
Sure.
Okay. Not bad.
Yeah.
All right, well, I'm going to go ahead and turn it down a little bit.
We're definitely not going to have it that high.
Yeah, I think the upstairs probably wouldn't appreciate that too much, but hey, at least it's got the capability. So thanks for letting us destroy and also upgrade your house. And thanks to Intel for sponsoring this episode. Guys, you can always find out more about the latest Intel 10th gen processors and all their other great technology at the link down below. Stay tuned, make sure you're subscribed because we're gonna have more of these coming. And I already know that at least the next four or five are gonna have utterly unique spins because every person at Linus Media Group is, let me just put it this way, they're all a little special.